Carolina Pacheco. Carolina, I'm sorry. You're a producer of television and all sorts of different television programs. You took an untraditional academic path to be a TV film producer. Can you briefly describe to the audience how and why your untraditional academic path brought you to TV production?
It's unusual because most people get that a producer end up working, you know, studying film. I moved here from Argentina and I studied anthropology, so not really related. But because I really love history, I ended up working for the History Channel back when they did history programming. They are not into that anymore. But it was really cool. The thing that was good about the fact that I didn't go to film school is that you can really learn the trade at work, and you learn from the bottom. You know, I started at the bottom and worked my way up, and that sort of allowed me to see all these different departments. I worked in post-production when I started, then I moved on to production, and because of that, I learned what everyone did on set. And that helped me a lot in the production, you know, getting hired as a producer, because I know how everybody has to work, and hiring people, I know what to expect of them and what they're supposed to bring to the table. And the best thing I can tell you is, like, even if you don't study film, a lot of what Karen was saying, like, people that study film get out of film school thinking, I'm a director, so that I go to set and I get hired as a PA, you know, production assistant, and I get to direct. It's like, no, you're going to have to pick up coffee and, you know, get dirty and work crazy hours and get paid $100 a day. But that's really how you learn the trade. And if you do everything with passion and you're committed to what you're doing, it's going to be hard at first, but you learn from every job all the time, just from the experience. And the best thing I can tell you is, if you're passionate about cupcakes or anthropology or whatever it is that you're passionate about, usually you can bring that into production because it's so diverse. There's such a diverse field. You know, because I know Spanish, speak Spanish, obviously. I got to go to Colombia to shoot a documentary about Shakira for MTV, if you were interested in. A lot of what you are interested in, you should pursue. I think the richer you are as an individual, just in general in any career, you know, pursuing your passions, I think the better you're going to be in what you do, because you're going to bring to the table things that other people might not have. In my case, I liked history, but, you know, whatever it is that you're interested in, I think you can bring it to your career. And that's the best I can tell you for in production. I got to travel around the world because I live, you know, I like traveling so much. And you're saying before, like, I get to go shoot in Europe because I speak Spanish and French a little bit, so I can work on location. And that was so exciting always to do. And because I did all the different jobs, I know how to cover for a lot of the holes. And documentaries have really low budget, so you need to know how to do everything, because if the makeup artist doesn't show up, you have to be this person that puts it. It's just how it works. So, yeah, documentaries.